Dun da da dun da 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 dun. Alrighty, it is time for the third and final opportunity to make this blog look awesome. Feel free to use the blog that you've been working on, or if you want a fresh start, you can download a clean version in the downloadable section. And just like before, I'm going to give you some mandatory changes and some optional changes for the blog. As you set up in the first iteration of the blog, the images right now are basically just big enough so they look good on large, high DPI displays. The good news is that you're guaranteed to deliver high-quality images to everyone, but the bad news is that these images are probably too big for most devices. There's also the added issue of artwork, in that when the viewport is small, users are seeing a wide image and they may miss some of the most important elements. Like for instance here, on a phone, with a wide image of the horses, they just look like dots. You can't really make out any detail. Enter the picture element. For this part of the project, I want you to use the picture element to deliver different images based on viewport widths. And for some images, like the horses, I want you to display a different crop of the image based on browser width. So if the window gets small, crop it in so we can actually see the horses. It usually makes sense to show tighter and tighter crops of an image as the browser gets smaller. And remember, you can use the source set attribute to change which image is displayed based on device pixel ratio. Take advantage of this. In the solution, you'll see me set breakpoints at 500 and 750 pixels for my picture elements. I'll also set up images for 1x and 2x displays when the browser is larger than 750 pixels. And just like the first time you worked on the project, I'm giving you a boilerplate grunt file to help you get started. And once you're delivering fully responsive images with the picture element, make sure to add some descriptive alt tags if the images need them. As an optional challenge, you can make this blog look a little bit nicer. In the solution, you'll see me use the section tag to separate pieces of content. I'll add a new font from Google Fonts as well, and there might be a few other aesthetic changes to the text. So once you've used the picture tag with source set to deliver images based on different browser widths and display densities, and you've added alt attributes to all of your images, a code will appear on the screen. Type that code in here to continue. But hey, don't forget, this is your baby and this is an art. So try a new font and maybe style the text just a little bit better.